It's a moment scientists have warned of for some time, one they knew was coming and may signal bad news for our atmosphere. When a monitoring site in Hawaii found 400 parts of carbon dioxide per million in the air last week, a significant benchmark was passed. It's a sign emissions are continuing at a quick rate. One scientist said, "We have now passed a whole series of points of no return." Well, the news for nature sounds grim. As temperatures rise, the dangers of animals and plants being unable to adapt to the increase. Two men who have seen this at first hand are my guests today. They are behind a beautiful new book on the changing life of the Himalayas. Dr. Kamal Bawa is a professor of biology at the University of Massachusetts, and Sandesh Kadur is a wildlife filmmaker and photographer. I'm going to be speaking to them in a moment. First, though, take a look at some of Sandesh's work. I have to remember I'm about to do an interview because that always sweeps me away. I've seen it a few times today. Dr. Bawa and Sandesh Kadur are with me now. Sandesh, beautiful work. It's so lovely to watch that film. What is it? I mean, you've spent so much time in the Himalayas that for you makes it so special.
It's an area I hadn't been to not till 2009. And when I went there, I was blown away. It's everything's new. It's new landscape. It's a big landscape. And the possibility of discovering new things every day, that's what's exciting.
Dr. Bawa, you've got concerns though. What's your biggest worry?
I think at this time, biggest worry is climate change. And our work has shown that you mentioned carbon dioxide increase, and our own work has shown that temperature in the Himalayas has increased 3 times the global average during the last 20 years or
so. And why is that?
I think we attribute the increases in temperature due to increases in carbon dioxide content, which you referred to earlier. And already there have been the life in the Himalayas, unique biological diversity has been under considerable pressure. And now those changes are going to be made worse by the impact of climate change.
And have you witnessed some of these changes too, Sandesh, when you've been working there?
As a matter of fact, we were just talking about that on the way here. Dr. Bawa and I just came back from Bhutan, and I remember 3 years ago going to this one place with thermals on, and a few days ago, last week, when we were in the same place, same time of the year, I was burning up in my thermals because it wasn't required. So we've actually seen or felt the change in climate just in the last couple of years.
And what are local people saying about it?
Well, local people are very, very aware of what is happening. And we were actually quite surprised by that. We conducted a study of about 500 households in the Himalayas about a year ago and 2 years ago. And people are very, very aware of what is happening, increases in temperature, how global warming is affecting their agriculture and other
endeavors. And what have they said to you, Sandesh? Because at the end of the day, it's not just the environment, it's the people living there as well that are affected so much by this.
I think it's affected a lot of things, and people are feeling it. Like Dr. Bawa said, it's affecting agriculture, it's affecting what crops are planted at different elevations. So there's a lot of change happening, and people are having to adapt to those changes.
There are some things as well, though, of course, that are man-made. I know we have a photo here of a dam project in the Himalayas. What effect, Dr. Bawa, has that had?
I think we don't know fully the effects of the dam.
Explain where this one is, for instance, this picture.
I think this is an area in North Sikkim, and when Sandesh and I went to this area, It was fully covered. You could see a green river flowing at the valley of the at the bottom of the valley, and now you see all this construction of dam, of course, destroying the forest, aquatic diversity, freshwater diversity. I think it's probably all gone or will disappear very, very soon. And there are other effects on availability of water. Aquifers in the hills are being affected, and people are feeling this loss of water resources.
And Sandesh, how does it feel to take photos of this actually happening, knowing it's a man-made thing?
There's been a lot of places like this. This is just one example. You can imagine in 2009 that was a pristine river, and now it's just been completely destroyed. And at some point, at some level, you get connected to the places that you work in. So it's certainly, it affects you as an individual to see this change happening so quickly.
Okay, we're just looking. You just saw a lizard actually there, and that was what I was going to mention next. We do have this picture of a lizard that has had to adapt to climate change. Dr. Bauer, we're just going to bring that up in a moment. Explain to us about what's happening with some of the animals in this environment. We hope there he is. Here. Look,
yes.
He's remarkable, isn't he? He's had to change.
I think there are two points I want to mention. First of all, I think this lizard species, a new species we believe, was discovered just a couple of years ago when Sandesh led an expedition in one part of Arunachal Pradesh in the eastern Himalaya. So even we even don't know what's out there.
And isn't that remarkable that there are
right,
still things out there
right,
changing?
Right, exactly. And how this life is going to be affected, I think we don't know very much about how the species will respond to changes. A recent study has indicated that about half the species in the world will be affected one way or the other by climate change. About half the species.
Half the species, that is incredible. One of the photos I know you both wanted us to show is this lovely image we've got here for you of a boy holding a fish. Because it makes a very particular point, this photo, doesn't it, about how humans and nature need to work together. Sandesh, you must see this kind of image every day that you're there, but this is the future, isn't it?
That's true. That's true. And what this image shows is that the people in the area have no idea in terms of, like, the impacts on things that they're going to be eating, the sustainable use of fish. And one of the points that we wanted to make with this particular image is the disconnect between science and society, and that all of these things need to be integrated in order for us to bring about proper conservation measures in this landscape.
Dr. Bauer, is anything being done, efforts underway to try and protect this environment?
Indeed, a lot of things have been done. There is much more scientific activity in the Himalayas now than it was before. Many non-government organizations are working in the area to bring together people, governments, and of course nature to really pursue this integrated approach Sandesh talked about.
Well, I hope for all of us that there is some success. Gentlemen, thank you both very much for coming in. It's a beautiful book. I hope you have luck with it. Thank you.
Thank you.